Hi everyone, this is Marshall Mola, and in this video we are going to learn what is transactional leadership and its characteristics, pros and cons. So let's get started. Transactional leadership is built on a clear structure of reward and punishment for different levels of performance. It is focused on results, efficiency and performance rather than people and relationship. Transactional leadership is often seen as the opposite of transformational leadership, which we are going to talk about in the next video. There are several characteristics of transactional leadership, but here we are going to learn major three characteristics of transactional leadership. Number one, instruction, rules and guidelines to create clarity. In transactional leadership, the expectation from an employee is clearly defined and every employee knows what to do and how to do it and which behaviors are rewarded or punished. Number two, reward and punishment framework for incentivizing. Incentives are a major part of any transactional leadership approach. The framework should inform all employees what they need to do to obtain a bonus and how large it will be. Number three, results are the focus, not relationship. Transactional leadership is focused on result, not relationship. If you do not perform, it will not matter how nice you are. There simply will be no bonus or negative impact on your bonus. Every leadership style has its own advantages and disadvantages. For instance, in my last video, we talked about the pros and cons of bureaucratic leadership. The major advantages of transactional leadership are number one, employee who deliver results are rewarded. Number two, reward and punishment are clearly defined. Number three, short-term results can be achieved quickly. Number four, this can be very productive for target-based job. The major disadvantages of transactional leadership are number one, the sole focus on results can be demotivating and disengaging. Number two, rewards have a limited impact on people's performance. At some point, other factors start to matter more. Number three, strict structure hampers creativity and innovation. Number four, employees are blamed for the failure to meet targets. So now we are quite familiar with transactional leadership. So my question to you, when is transactional leadership most effective? Please let me know in the comments below. I will come back soon with another interesting video. Till then, keep learning, keep growing.